prepare tomorrow's leaders
by educating their minds,
nurturing the spirit,
and strengthening the body.
Hola, soy Andrés Morales. Soy de la clase de 2008 del Colegio Nueva Granada. Llevo acá 13 años desde Kinder 5. En el ICFES, pues como yo siempre quise estudiar en el exterior, no estudié mucho. No estudié nada y me saqué un 67 en total. Entonces, pues que hay más preparación que el colegio que me dio eso. En relación al proceso de College Counseling, pues yo la verdad llegué en agosto sin haber conocido para nada a María Lucía y llegué con unas ambiciones que yo creo que la sacaron un poco del agua. Ella siempre estuvo detrás mío en todo lo que yo quería hacer y me empujó completamente con los ensayos, con las aplicaciones, con todo y la verdad me guió mucho, mucho en el proceso. De todas las que apliqué me aceptaron en Stanford, Harvard, UPenn, Tufts y WPI. En Stanford me dieron una beca de $47,000. En WPI me gané un scholarship de $31,000.
Yo me llamo Juliana Bayona, me gradúo ahorita con la clase del 2008. Con el colegio nosotros solo tomamos el ICFES ahorita en abril una vez, porque es el momento en que califican al colegio. Sin embargo, muchos de nosotros decidimos tomar el ICFES desde antes, en octubre, con los colegios de calendario A. Cuando tomé el ICFES en octubre, lo que pasó fue que yo pensaba que el examen era más difícil y que no me iba a ir tan bien. De verdad, salí muy confiada del examen, pero dije, no puede ser tan fácil. Pues me fue bien, entonces sí lo hice, sí apliqué con los colegios de calendario A y pues me aceptaron a las dos universidades que apliqué, que fueron los Andes y la Javeriana.
Good afternoon, my name is Carla Sanchez and I'm a fifth grade math teacher in the elementary school at Colegio Nueva Granada. Basically, the curriculum alignment process is a way for the school to ensure that the curriculum or what we teach your students flows from kinder 4 all the way through 12th grade. It has been a wonderful process. The administration has been very supportive in the fact that we've been allowed to have a consultant, Dr. Janie Pollock, who has visited the school several times, I believe three or four times this year alone. And the advantage of having Dr. Pollock work with the school is that we have someone who is an expert in the field of aligning curriculums. But besides that, she is able to look at the work that we do periodically and see how we are advancing and what suggestions she could offer us in order to make it even better.
Starting this 2007-2008 school year, we decided to incorporate and implement a new test that's sponsored by the NWEA, and it's called the Measure of Academic Progress. This test is more beneficial to us because it provides us with consistent and continuous assessment and feedback on children's achievement levels throughout the school year. The primary advantages of the new MAP test is that, one, it's an adaptive test, meaning that as a student starts to take the test, the exam identifies their level of instruction and is able to provide them with more difficult questions if needed, or questions that are possibly a little bit below their what they're doing and how they're answering. So in the end, you're actually receiving a individualized assessment for each child based on their knowledge and their background and their experiences. So it really does provide us with specific information about each and every child who takes the test.
Hello, I'm Ms. Elise Krantz. I'm a third grade teacher.
And I'm Cameron Ritchie, and I'm her student.
And today we're going to go over Cameron's MAP test results from January, and we're going to talk about her progress and how we can continue improving with her results. Now what's happened is you've already really improved even past what we hoped for June, so that's great. Congratulations. Your weakness this time is in evaluative comprehension. Now, what does that mean? That means that identifying fact and opinion and comparing and contrasting things was giving you some trouble. So what do you think are some things we could do to help you in that area?
Well, maybe I could like read magazine and newspaper articles and then identify fact and opinion and write about it in my reading response letter.
Another advantage is that it's computer-based, so that means that students are taking the test in a computer lab, they receive immediate feedback as to their scores as soon as the test is finished, and then 24 hours later, after we've uploaded the data to the system, we as a school receive feedback and receive information about the children and about the different groups. We want students to be taking ownership of their learning and trying to make goals and push themselves forward.
Okay. Well, I think those are excellent ideas, and I'm sure you're going to continue to make great progress. If you could sign here, and then we'll send them home to your parents to look at. I'm sure they will be very proud. This round of testing, the parents have been really excited to see if their students have met their goals and how they can help them in that. So it's kind of involved them more with a specific goal in mind, not just, you know, improve reading.
I felt good sharing the results with my parents because I let them know that how I was doing in school.
Hi, I'm Freddie Badillo. I'm the CNG Athletic Director. The FitnessGram arrived here at CNG this year. There's several areas that the FitnessGram evaluates. It's aerobic capacity, it's strength, endurance, which is that goes with muscular strength and muscular endurance, as well as flexibility. What we can conclude in the first test given to the CNG students of the FitnessGram is that we fare very well in the body mass index. Where we need improvements are in flexibility and aerobic capacity. We're going to attempt to improve by 10% the aerobic capacity and the flexibility of all children. The great thing about the FitnessGram is also it gives immediate feedback to students as well as parents.
My name is Daniela Paternina. I'm in sixth grade. When I was giving the results of my test, I found that I'm in a normal physical shape. I'm not in the best one, but I'm in a good one. I play volleyball and the FitnessGram helps me improve because I get a lot of strength in my arms and I can see what point am I in the fitness way. I set goals like maybe to make more push-ups and gain more strength in my arms. I think next testing I'm going to improve because I've made a lot of hard work.
CNG has been using Ventures for Excellence for over 6 years now. They use it as a tool for identifying and recruiting excellent teachers. Over the past couple of years, there's been a little bit of a change in focus, and we've been using Ventures for Excellence more for strengthening the skills and abilities of teachers that are currently on staff. I think it's really important that people embrace and take on some of the ideas from Ventures. Primarily because it's hard to improve if you don't really know where you are. Some of the tools that Ventures gives us, it identifies what we're strong at, where we need to improve, we get feedback from parents, we can construct professional growth plans. Basically, I'm all for it. If we're going to improve and get better at what we're doing, then we need a starting point and we need that data. And that's what Ventures has provided for us.
last 2 years, we have made significant investments in improving our facilities, purchasing technological equipment, and buses for the school.